It feels like beer brewers will do anything to spice up their booze. There's pizza beer, banana split chocolate stout, beer with squid ink, and of course, Rocky Mountain Oyster Stout, which is flavored with bull testicles. All this fuss seems silly when the foundation of alcohol's flavor is plain old yeast. Yeast, these little microbes that take sugars and ferment them into alcohol, define a beer's character. Yet for 10,000 years, beers have essentially relied on two types of bland yeast that basically add no flavors. Now, a lab in North Carolina has discovered a new yeast species that produces an array of flavors without added ingredients. Where'd they find it? On bees. The story of Bumble Beer begins at North Carolina State University in the lab of Rob Dunn. Once a tropical forest ecologist, Dunn now explores the jungle that surrounds us, the one filled with bugs and microbes.
At some point, my lab shifted to focusing more on people's daily lives, and that includes food and includes thinking about the biology of food.
One day 3 years ago, a colleague inquired if the lab knew of any microbes in the environment capable of making beer. Dunn and company instantly considered insect pollinators, like bees and wasps. Here's why. Yeast hang out in flower nectar, where the microbes feast on the boatloads of sugar. They then produce or ferment sweet aromas, which then attract the buzzing bugs.
We actually think, based on some work from colleagues in Italy, that it's very likely that those first beers and breads were relying on yeast from insects too.
Back then, a bug carrying a fermenting yeast may have fallen into some wet grain, and boom, welcome to the booze cruise. In fact, some scientists argue human agriculture started just to mass produce grains to make beer. The more beer we drink, the more yeast we have to grow.
Unambiguously, the most successful organism in the world is yeast. And so if you think about all of the yeast we make everywhere for many of the products we make, they won.
But today, where would you even start looking for a new beer-making yeast?
Part of this is science, and part of this feels more like an art that's hard to describe.
Meet Ann Madden, the Dunn Lab's microbe wrangler. To search for an unknown yeast, she started by catching a wild bee and a wild wasp. She then transferred every microbe from their bodies to a petri dish. Don't fret, she didn't commit mass bugicide.
To make Bumble Beer and all of the different Bumble Beers that we've made since, we've killed two bugs. You've likely killed more bugs on your way to a bar to get beer than we did in the process of making it.
A couple days later, a forest of microbes appear on the dish. Then in four steps, Madden combines her senses with technology. First, she looks to separate the yeast from bacteria or fungi.
It's about understanding when something glistens in a certain way.
Next, she picks a handful of yeast candidates, grows them on a new dish, and then follows her nose.
You can smell the same smell, both on that plate and in that final beer.
Her third task is running the DNA from these candidates through a national database to ensure her picks don't cause disease.
It's almost like a Google search through all other species that exist that have been documented.
The final step is a chemical test, because despite the long history of brewing, the genes and enzymes responsible for fermentation are largely unknown. The survivors of this gauntlet land with John Sheppard in NC State's research brewhouse.
In traditional beers that are lighter in character, like the traditional American lager, for example, you don't want to overwhelm your taste, and so what the yeast does is very important. A lot of wild yeast, which are considered contamination in a normal brewing process, the reason why they're not wanted is because they produce a lot of off flavors that are not really desirable in the beer. So to get a wild yeast that doesn't produce these off flavors can be difficult. So we did a little testing to see whether or not the yeast strains would be able to make beer. And we selected one, it came from a wasp, because this special yeast not only makes ethanol, but makes acid. And as a result of that, we had a natural sour beer.
The Bumble Beer yeast make other flavors too, like a sweet honey taste without the addition of actual honey. Craft sour beers often take months or years to make. Bumble Beer yeast can do the same in a matter of weeks. Local brewers have taken notice. The first suds made with Bumble Beer yeast rolled out earlier this year. And Until next time, I'm Nsikan Akpan, and this is ScienceScope from the PBS NewsHour.